Hey guys, Moran Pober here with another video, and this video is going to be all about how to figure out if the seller is really motivated to sell your business, to sell his business or not. Let's get to it. Now remember, this channel is all about how to buy and grow businesses and how to make sure we have a management team in place to operate the business for us and how you can do that even if you don't have much capital or experience or track record or credit. So if you want to hear more, subscribe, like this video, and let me know in the comments below what kind of business you want to own. And also in the description below, I started this survey where you can literally post your biggest question. So you put in the details, you tell me what are your biggest questions, and I'll create personalized videos for you, because I want to start to upload on a day-to-day basis and I need ideas for topics, and one of you will win 12 weeks of one-on-one mentorship on how to buy businesses, and you'll have the option to work with me, my team, my partners, everything, and also partner with us on deals. So definitely check in the comments below. And also in the description below, go and join our Facebook mastermind, Business Buying Mastermind, if you didn't yet. And that's it. Let's start the video. So if you're watching this channel, you know, we have a process. We go out there, we put ourselves out there, we talk to business owners, we then receive financials and information about the business, and we start to make offers. But before you make offers, before you do your financial analysis, the question is, how can you know if the business owner is serious about selling his business or not, right? Because we don't want to waste too much time on creating business plans and financial analysis and forecasts and things like that before we know if we actually have a potential deal here or not. So what do we do? And in a nutshell, the best way to know if you're in the ballpark, at least, of being around motivated seller, or if you're in the ballpark of doing a deal, is to send your first offer. And that's what we call an IOI, or indication of interest. And that's basically the first opportunity for you to know, hey, if I'm even in the game or not. Before that, I wouldn't spend too much time on a deal before you send an offer, and at least know kind of like the basic understanding of where you're at. And with this basic offer letter, you basically send the overall terms of the deal and the overall price of the deal. When you send that, I mean, guys, that's the only way to know if you actually have a legit seller or not. I mean, before you make an offer, he can sell you the world. He can tell you so much about himself, his family, his plans for the exit and all that. But before he actually gonna get an actual offer in his hands, you can't know. I mean, some of those people, remember, they're selling their business for their first time and the only time maybe that they'll ever sell a business. This is literally their life, their baby, their ego. Everything is invested into this thing, and all their employees and all their heritage and everything, all their life, this is their baby. So you only know if they're really, really serious when you actually put an offer in front of them. Before that, yes, you can assume, you can obviously, over time, when you talk to many, many business owners, you'll eventually get a sense and have the right questions to ask and the right systems to filter through deals faster when you get an experience. But you'll only really know if you can move forward on a deal and if the seller is serious when you put in front of him the first offer. Now, a key thing to remember is that the first offer that you're sending, the IOI, the offer letter, isn't binding on any side. So it's not on you or the other side. You're not obligated to anything. This is just literally an offer to say, hey, this is what we're up to, what do you think? And to basically start the real legit conversation going. Now, the IOI is not formal at all. I mean, the only reason for you to send the IOI, or that initial offer, is to figure out if there's an agreement on the overall pricing and structure. And like I said, you don't have to keep it formal. Like, literally, this kind of offer can be done on the phone. There are other ways to do it. I can expand on that. But basically, just keep it casual, keep it normal. This is what we kind of like offer. And we just try to figure out if we're even in the ballpark and in the game. And remember, when you send that offer, even if you get a no, you can really understand and sense at this stage if the seller is serious or not. Because if you're getting a hard no, like saying, hey, there's no way, we're not even close, then you know, hey, there's no way to do this deal because we're not even in the ballpark of that deal or in the range that we are looking to do. But if at the same time you're getting a more subtle response saying, hey, I got the offer, thank you, but I think we need to look at ABC in order to be in the game, then you understand there's something to work with and there's a better chance to close the deal. So the first offer is basically to just make you understand, hey, is there even a chance here, or it's like a 100% no, or there's a place to work with here. And then you basically get that based on the response that you're getting from the owner. Now, based on the response you're getting, you can now know the next steps. Now, when you're sending your first offer, ideally you already have some financial institutions aligned and you need to understand what kind of financing you can do for those deals. And when you send those offers, ideally you even show some basically proof of funds. When you send those offers, you can say that it's all subject to raising the capital, but that's going to make you look not as a credible buyer or an investor. So it's up to you how you want to present it. Ideally, at this stage, you already need to have financing aligned. You need to know how much you can pay exactly, because otherwise you wouldn't make the offer. You want to know exactly or potentially how much you can pay. You need to figure out if you're in the ballpark, and you need to figure out at this stage kind of like what's the response you're getting from the seller. Now, when you're sending those letters, let's expand a bit. You can do it in a few ways. You can send it as a PDF attached to an email. You can send it as a fax if you're still using one. You can send it directly to the owner, or if you're dealing with a broker, you can send it to the broker. So again, up to you. You can even do it on the phone and just say, hey, look, this is our terms. This is what we think we can offer, and we want to figure out if we're in the ballpark. Just pick whatever you feel comfortable with. Ideally, if you're sending a letter or a PDF or a fax, have some kind of a company cover letter if you want to look more serious, but it's not a must. In the offer, it's really important that you include the overall price you're willing to pay for the business. You need to say how much you're willing to pay at closing and how much you really need to pay on deferred base over a period of time. Now, hopefully after you send the offer and get a yes, this is when you can dive into basically writing down the head of terms, where it's really when you really dive into exact details of the deals. But remember, before that, before you get a basic acceptance on your overall deal and structure, you don't need to get into head of terms and into exclusivity. You need to first of all figure out if you're even in the range. And if you're getting a yes, if you're getting a no and you're getting rejected, it's all good. Just go back to your model, figure out if you can potentially offer a better offer, or maybe you need to go out there and raise more capital. But a no is sometimes, if it's not a hard no, it's just not yet. Or you just need to figure out more things. Maybe you need to go out and raise some more capital from individuals or bring in capital from your own. So it's up to you. And obviously it depends on how much do you really want the deal, or maybe you just want to decide to skip that and go to different deal because there are abundance of deals. So it's up to you at this stage where you want to take things. Now, even if you can make a better offer, remember, don't make the second better offer after a day or so of getting a no. Wait at least a few days, show that you're serious, that you actually went out there and did your best to come up with a better offer. It looks amateurish, let's say, in a nice word, where you get a no for a deal right now and then a day later you come and make an offer for $500,000 more or $1 million more on a business. It just looks like you're just not looking good. And at the end of the day, you want to show that you really do your best and do whatever you can for everyone to win. And even if you raised your offer, show that you work hard for it. Even if it's true or not, it can be both ways. Obviously, it depends on your negotiation strategies. And there's another video I created on how to negotiate those different offer types. So go and watch that if you want. Remember, just wait with a different offer. Wait at least few more days, ideally at least a week, and before you send the next offer. So that's it for today. Pretty short video. I hope you enjoyed it. Subscribe, like the video, share with friends that you ideally want to own business with. I think it's awesome to have partners that you like and you can all work together and buy more businesses and have different operators running them for you. So definitely subscribe, share it, and see the description below. Let me know of different ideas on what kind of videos you want me to talk about. Just put the description, check the description below, fill the survey, put your details, and I'll create personalized videos for you. And join the free video, free Facebook Business Mind Mastermind if you didn't yet. And that's all. I'll see you soon. I hope you enjoyed it and talk to you soon.